You think maximum and minimum of a function of several variables related by given equation, conditional maximum and minimum. Take your copy books, take your pen and begin your writing. Maximum and minimum of a function of several variables related by given equation conditional maxima and minima. In many maximum and minimum problems, one has to find the extrema of a function of several variables that are not independent but are related to one another by side condition. For example, they must satisfy a given equation. By way of illustration, let us consider the following problem. Using a piece of tin 2A. And area it is required to build a closed box in the form of parallelepiped of maximum volume. Denote the length, width, and height on box by x, y, and z. The problem reduces to finding the maximum of function v is x times y times z. Provided z 2 x y plus 2 x z plus 2 y z equals 2 a. The problem has deals with a conditional extremum. The variable x, y, z are restricted by the condition that 2x y plus 2x z plus 2yz is 2a. In this section, we shall consider methods of solving such problems. Let us first consider the equation of the condition extremum of a function of two variables, if these variables are restricted by a single condition. Let it be required to find the maxima and minima of the function USF of XY. Formula 1. With the proviso that x and y are connected by the equation phi of xy equals 0. Formula 2. Given condition 2 of the two variables x and y, there will be only one which is independent for instant x, since y is determined from 2 as a function of x. Write down it. Given condition 2, of the two variables x and y, there will be only one which is independent for an instance X since Y is determined from 2 as a function of X. It resolved equation 2 for y and put into 1 the expression found in place of y, we would obtain a function of one variable x and would reduce the problem to one that would involve finding the maximum and minimum of a function of the independent variable x. But the problem may be solved without solving equation 2 for x or y. For those values of x at which the function u can have a maximum and minimum, the derivative of u with respect to x should vanish. From 1, we find du over dx. Remembering that y is a function of x, du over dx will be equal to df rounded over dx plus df over dy, but y is a function of x because we must multiply by dy full derivative over dx because y depend of x. Hence, at the point of extremum, df over dx plus df over dy times dy over dx equals 0, formula 3. From equation 2 that we wrote down here, phi of x, y is 0. From this equation, we find d phi over dx plus d phi over dy times dy over dx equals 0, equation 4. This equality is satisfied for all x and y that satisfy equation 2. Multiplying the term of 4, this 4, by n as yet indeterminate coefficient lambda and adding them to the corresponding terms of 3, this 3, we have df over dx plus df over dy times dy over dx bracket plus lambda times m d phi over dx plus d phi over dy times dy over dx close bracket equals 0. Or d phi over dx plus lambda times d phi over dx in bracket plus df over dy plus lambda d phi over dy times dy over dx equals 0. Expression 5. The latter equality is fulfilled at all extremum points. Choose lambda such that for the value of x and y, which correspond to the extremum of the function u, the second parenthesis in 5 should vanish, df over dy plus lambda d phi over dy equals 0. But then for these values of x and y from 5 we have df over dx plus lambda d phi over dx, this bracket equals 0. It just turns out the extremum points, three equations with three unknowns x, y, and lambda are satisfied. Df over dx plus lambda d phi over dx is 0. Df over dy plus lambda d phi over dy is 0 and phi of xy is 0 too. System 6. From these equations, determine x, Why at London? The letter only played an auxiliary role and will not be needed anymore. From this conclusion, it follows that equation 6 are necessary conditions of a conditional extremum, or equation 6 are satisfied at the extremum points. But there will not be a conditional extremum for every x and y and lambda that satisfy equation 6. A supplementary investigation of the nature of the critical point is required in the solution of concrete problems. It is sometimes possible to establish the character of the critical point from the statement of the problem. It will be noted that the left-hand sides of equation 6 are partial derivatives of the function, the left-hand sides equation 6 are partial derivatives of the function f of x, y, lambda equals f of x, y plus lambda times phi of x, y. 7. With respect to the variables x, y, and lambda. Thus, in order to find the values of x and y which satisfy condition 2, for which the function u is f of xy can have a conditional maximum or a conditional minimum, one has to construct an auxiliary function 7. This function equate to 0 its derivatives with respect to x, y, and lambda. And from the three equation 6 in the system 6, thus obtain determine the sought for x, y in the auxiliary factor lambda. The foregoing method can be extended to a study of the conditional extremum of a function of any number of variables. Let it be required to find the maxima and minima of a function of n variables. U is f of x first, x second, etc. to xn. Provided that the variables x first, x second, etc. to xn are connected by m, if m is less than n, equations. Phi first of x first, x second, etc. to xn equals 0. Phi second of x first, x second, etc. to xn equals 0. 0 is etc. to phi m, m is less than n of x first, x second, etc. to xn equals 0. System 8. In order to find the values of x first, x second, etc. to xn, for which there may be conditional maxima and minima, one has to form the function f of x first, x second, etc. to xn, lambda first, lambda second, etc. to lambda m equals f of x first to xn plus lambda first times phi first of x first to xn plus lambda second times phi second of x first to xn plus etc. to lambda m times phi m of x first to xn. Equate to 0 its partial derivatives with respect to x first, x second, etc. to xn. Df of dx first plus lambda first d phi first over dx first plus etc. to lambda m d phi m over dx first equals 0. Same with respect to dx second. And then to the variable xs. The system nine, and from the m plus n equations 8 and 9, determine x first, x second, etc. to x n, and the auxiliary unknowns lambda first, etc. to lambda m. Just as in the case of a function of two variables, we shall in the general case leave undecided the equation of the function for the values found will have a maximum or minimum, or will have neither. We will decide this matter on the basis of additional reasoning. Consider the examples. Example 1. Let us return to the problem formulated at the beginning of this section to find the maximum of the function v is x, y, z, x times y times z, provided that x, y plus x, z plus y, z equals minus a, maybe, equals 0. Where x is greater than 0, y is greater than 0, and z is greater than 0. We form the auxiliary function. F of x, y, lambda equals x, y, z, our function v, plus lambda times x, y plus x, z plus y, z minus a. Find its partial derivatives and equate them to 0. Df over dx. Derivative of the first term of our function with respect to x will be y times z. Because we consider that y and z is constant, x is variable, derivative of x with respect to x is 1. And we have yz. Then plus lambda. We must find derivative with respect to x. Derivative of xy is y. Derivative of xz is z plus z. Derivative of yz with respect to x is 0 because we don't see the variable x in this term. And derivative of constant minus r, a is 0 too. And all this expression equals 0. The first. Derivative of our function capital F with respect to y. It is derivative of x, y, z with respect to y is x, z. Plus lambda. Derivative of x, y with respect to y is x. Derivative of x, z is 0. Derivative of y, z is z. And this 0 too. And the third derivative with respect to that z. Derivative of x, y, z with respect to z is xy, just xy. Plus lambda. Derivative of xy with respect to z equals 0. Because not z. Derivative of xz with respect to z is x, and derivative of yz is y. Derivative of a 0. And all of this equals 0. It is 11. 11. Here maybe 10 in this root. The problem reduces to solving a system of four equations. 10 and 11. In four unknowns x, y, z and lambda. To solve this system, multiply the first of equations 11, the first, by x. The second, by y, multiply. The third, by z. Add. Taking 10 into account, we find that lambda is 3xyz over 2a. Putting these values of lambda into equation 11, we get yz times 1 minus 3x over 2a times y plus z equals 0. X, z times 1 minus 3y over 2a times x plus z equals 0, and x, y times 1 minus 3z over 2a times x plus y equals 0. Since it is evident from the statement of the problem that x, y, z are different from 0, we get from the later equation 3x over 2a times y plus z equals 1, 3y over 2a times x plus z equals 1, and 3z over 2a times x plus y equals 1. From the first two equations, we find x is y. From the second and third equation, y is z. But then from equation 10, we get x equals y equals z is square root of a over 3. This is the only system of values of x, y, and z for which there can be a maximum or minimum. It can be proved that the solution obtained yields a maximum. Incidentally, that is also evident from geometrical reasoning, the statement of the problem indicated that the one of the box cannot be big without wound. It is therefore natural to expect that for some definite values of the side, the volume will be a maximum. Thus, for the volume of the box to be a maximum, the box must be a cube in each of which is equal to
Square root of a over 3. It was example 1. Now we have 5 minute rest and then we continue. Good?